Good morning, students. How are you all? Okay, I hope all are fine. So today's class, we are going to learn about that's the next topic, children. Have you all written the half yearly examination well? Say yes or no, children. Yes. So all are written well. Good. Very good. Very good, children. So okay. So today's class we are going to learn about the second chapter, the last, finally the gymnosperm. There only given that one of the tyrosperm, cycas. Okay, that is the one of the leftover portion, children. So that one is we are going to see today. Okay. So first of all, this is cycas. Cycas. If we are going to learn about its cycas, so at that time we are going to first learn about the systematic position of cycas. Okay, systematic position of cycas. What is the class name? So that they comes under an Cycadopsida, or otherwise they comes under Cycadales family, Cycadales in genus cycas. Okay, so this is the systematic position of cycas. Okay, the next one. So which are the species, or they comes under it, that is a common species of this cycas means. So there is they comes under cycas rivalveta, cycas sarsinalis, cycas rumphii. Okay, so these are the certain species are they comes under available of this common species in our world. Okay, so this is widely that is distributed in a tropical and subtropical region of the world. And then, so this is the plant body. So that is the plant body is they comes under a sporophyte in nature. Okay, so just like they resembles, they just similar to that sir, the palm like appearance. Okay, the small palm like appearance only. That's a sporophytic nature. Then, so that's a plant. So if we are looking, that's a plant. Cycas means that's a growth rate is very slow, children. So that is the evergreen type of this plant. So that's a xerophytic in nature. Okay, that's a xerophytic in nature. The next one, sporophyte. So the sporophyte, we are differentiated into, we can clearly differentiated into that's a root, stem and leaf regions. Okay, root, stem and leaf region. So here we are going to learn about that's a external features of this sporophyte and then internal structure of the sporophyte. So that's the things that we are going to learn separately, children. First one, what is the nature of this is that the stem region means. So that's a columnar stem. So they bearing in that is a crown like appearance of the spirally arranged pinnately gummed leaves or bases. Okay, so that's a stem. So there is the columnar like structures that is they presence in a pinnately gummed leaves. Pinnately gummed leaves means only 1 meter. So there is presence. So that is we are called a pinnately gummed leaves. Okay, that's the arrangement is spiral manner. Clear, children? Yes. The next one we are going to learn about is the external structure of this, the external characteristic features of the root system. Okay, but first of all, so the root is they are comes under in the cycas plant is two types, even one is taproot and another one is sporuloid root. Okay, one is taproot and another one is sporuloid root. The taproot means, so the primary root that one is they persist to forming in that's the taproots. That's the taproot system, the normal things. Then, so coralloid root means, so here that is their presence in a, first of all that's a primary taproot system, the primary root that is persisted to forming in a taproot. From that is the taproot system, there is a lateral roots are arising, children. That lateral roots are they gives rise to branches, just they growing in a vertical upward direction, but that is the below the ground level only growing. Okay, below the ground level only, that's a vertical growing of this lateral root, children. Not growing in that so that's the outside of this soil region. Clear? So here, what does mean by coralloid root means? So here they produces, this is the coralloid root. Okay, so this is the coralloid root, children. So here they produces in that is branches, they dichotomously branch the coral like appearance. Okay, so this is the coral like appearance. appearance. That's a dichotomous leaf branch, coral like appearance of the roots. So that is why this root is here called as a coralloid root. Understood, ma? So here, this is the coralloid root, that's a cortex region. So if we are taking in a section, clearly we can see that's a cortex region, children. Outermost layer is epiglamma, inside that's a region is we are called cortex. That's a cortex region, they present in one of this organ species. That's one of this blue-green organ species, children. So that's a blue-green organ species, that's an example of the species is Anabaena. Okay, the example of the species is Anabaena. What is the major duty for this blue-green algal varieties means? So that one is, they helps to fixing of this nitrogen in that's a plant. Okay, so that's a particular plant to fixing, that's it to help to fix of this nitrogen. Clear, children? Are you understood, ma'am? Say yes or no? So this is the one of the overall view of this external features of the root. Clear? The next one is stem. What about the stem characteristic features? Okay, so the next one is we are going to learn about its stem. So this is the examples of cycas plants. So this is the stem regions. Clear? Yes. What about the stem feature means? So the stem is the columnar like structures. There is not reduces in the branches, children. That the stem is very woody in nature. Understood? So here, that is a stem that is covered by that is a very, that is the woody type of the leaf basis stresses. Okay, that is woody type of the resistant leaf basis stresses. So the stem then also they produces if there is a the side in the lateral region. So they produces if that is the adventitious buds. That is a basal part only they produces in the adventitious buds. Adventitious buds, so that means they helps to growing of this new plants. Understood, children? Yes, very good. The next one is we are going to learn about that is the external features of this leaf part. Okay. So here there is a two type of the leaves, children. One is foliage or assimilatory leaves. Then so this the type of the leaf only they mainly they involving in a photosynthesis function. Okay. Then second one is scale leaves. The scale leaves major function is the protection. Okay. So here they present in a that's a woody type of this very dry type of the scale leaf is there, children. So that is they giving in a protection. Foliage leaves means so they giving in that is the function of this photosynthesis. But first of all we are going to learn about that is a foliage leaves. The foliage leaves, so here that's a leaf size is the very long term. Okay, so there which type of this lineation is present means that's a pinnately compound leaves are present. So here finally there is crown at the top of this region. So this is the crown at the top of the region they presence in the pinnately the compound leaves are present. So each leaf, suppose if we are taking in this one single leaf, clear? The each leaf, so they how many leaflets are present means 80 to 100 pairs of the sessiles. The same means without petiole. Clear? So that's the type of the leaflet is present, children. So what about the nature of this? That's the apex, that's the tip of the leaf region means there is very acute and spiny. So that's mean by sharp and so that is the that's the spines like structures of this characteristic features is the presence in the leaf edge region. I mean leaf tip region. Clear? Yes. So here then also the leaflet has also that's a single midway region is present. The lateral veins are totally absent. Okay. So there is the only one midway region. That's the lateral region. There is no veins as presence in that one. So here what is mean by ramenta? Ramenta means just a one of this that's a leaf basis or that's just like a hairy outgrowth like structure is present, children. So that hairy outgrowth like structure is we are called a ramenta. But so here what is mean by succinate lineation? So which type of the lineation is present in that one means? So here that's a leaf sort the roll from that is the apex towards the base region. Okay, from that is the apex towards that's the base region. So they are just they folded like a dog tails like stretches. Okay, so this dog tails like stretches, mostly this one is the varieties there we have seen in the fawn varieties only. Anyway, so this type of the venations we are calling, its name is known as a circinate venation. Clear? A circinate venation means the leaves were rolled from apex regions towards the base. So yeah, like a tail like dog. Okay, so that is the venation is we are called a circinate venation. So this one is it presents only that is the younger leaf. Clear, children? That younger leaf they covered with that ramenta. Okay, ramenta means already I told that one. So a small outgrowth like structures. Okay, so that is we are called that name is known as ramenta. Clear, children? So these are the items are they presents in the foliage leaf, or that is the assimilatory leaf mainly. So that is they involved in the functions of very good photosynthesis. The next one, scaly leaves. Scaly leaves. What about the characteristic features of scaly leaves? Means that is very small leaves, brown color of the leaves. So there is they presents in a triangular in shape. So that is resistant of this leaf. So this one also they covered with a ramenta, but that's the major function of this scale leaves is that they giving off this protections in that particular leaf region. Understood, ma'am? So these are the characteristic features of foliage or assimilatory leaf or scale leaves. Understood? Yes. Next one as we are going to learn about that is the internal structure of this cycas. So here it's your syllabus, they are given that's a four internal structures, children. Four parts of the plants. So first one is, so that is the root, that's a coralloid root. And second one is, so that's a stem transverse section. And the next one is rachis transverse section. The last one is leaf transverse section. Okay, these four questions are very very important. So each questions they will ask, that's a 5-mark pattern. Okay, diagram with the explanation. Let us learn one by one. Okay, children, are you ready to learn? Yes, good. First of all, the transverse section of root, or that is the coralloid, TS of coralloid root. Okay, suppose if we are taking in a, it's a coralloid root, so that one they shows that's a these four parts. Clear? What are the four, what are the parts, children? So the first layer is the epiblemma, cortex and vascular tissues or vascular regions. Clear? So here all of you look at this diagram. So first region is, I said that, you know, epiblemma, this is the outermost layer of the root, so that is we are called epiblemma. Clear? The next one is cortex region. Cortex region means from here to up to this, so we are called a cortex. So that's the binding of this cortex. So the here, that's the innermost cortex is we are called, that's name is known as endodermis. Okay, so that's the innermost layer of the cortex is we are called, that's name is known as endodermis. Understood, ma? Says or no? Yes. Then finally, inside this vascular bundle, sorry, inside the endodermis, they presence in a many layer of the pericycle, children. That pericycle inside they presence in a xylem and phloem elements. The xylem and phloem elements along with the pith and along with pericycle, all the spots are together, we are telling in that is a steel region or vascular regions. Understood, ma? Vascular bundles region. Clear? So these are the three regions to show that, sir, if we are taking in a transverse section of root. Okay, let us learn one by one. First one is epiblemma. Already I told you, epiblemma means, so that is the outermost region of the root is we are called, the name is known as epiblemma. Understood? So that's the outermost layer. So there, so which type of this is the paramagnetic cells, which is the type of the cells are present means, so they found in a paramagnetic cells. How many layers they presence means only one layer. Okay, that's a single layer of the paramagnetus, that's the outermost layer of the root is we are called, that's name is known as epiblemma. It's your diagram, they are representing it, that is the epidermis, that's wrong, children. So that there you have to be marked, that is epiblemma. So all of you listen, the leaf and stem, okay, that is the outermost layer is we are called epidermis. Clear? Root is outermost layer is calling that is the epi blamma. Understood ba? Yes. The next layer is the cortex layer. So this one, they follow to they coming in this layer. Okay, so that is we are called, that's the name is known as cortex. That is cortex is, so they presence in a many layer. So there they presence in, that's the paranemata cells, children. So this paranemata cells, then finally the end of this cortex layer, there they presence in a single layer of the paranemata cell, this one blue color. Okay, so that's a this is the layer. So this is we are called, that's name is known as endodermis. Okay, then so if we are looking in, this is the endodermis. Inside that one there is multi-layer. Okay, so there is the multi-layer parenchymatous pericycle cell is present, children. So that one is, they surround the cell, that one is they cover, that is the vascular tissues. Understood, ma'am? Yes. Then vascular tissues, what are the elements or the presence inside the vascular tissues, children? Can you able to say? Very good, children. Good, very good. Say xylem and phloem elements. Very good. Then what about the nature of the xylem elements and the phloem elements is present in a young root and older root means? So here the xylem is dioic condition. What's mean by dioic means? The two bundles of xylem is present means, that is we are called a dioic condition. Okay, the dioic condition is, the dioic condition of the xylem is present means, that is the representation of this young root. Clear? Suppose that is the older one means, so there they presence in a tetrarch condition of the xylem. Tetra means four, am I correct? That's a four bundles of the xylem elements as present means, that is the condition as we are called a older ones. Okay, by younger ones, how many xylem bundles children? Very good. Dyarch condition, that's mean by two vascular bundles, and tetrarch means that's a four xylem bundles. Clear? So that is they presence in the older ones. Then here, so at the same time, so this is the TS of this coralloid root also same one. This is the normal root, normal tap root only I told you, that's the first topic. Okay, then suppose if we are taking in, that's a TS of coralloid root also, the same concept only repeating, children. But additionally I am going to tell that one. Okay, so what is the additional oneness they presence inside the cortex of this coralloid root means? So there they presence in a one of this middle cortex area. Okay, so this is the part, so this is the middle cortex area. This middle cortex area, so there they presence in a, already I told you, so that's a coralloid root, there they found in a one of this algal species. Do you remember that's a species of algae? Very good, anabina. Clear? That anabina species, that is the presence inside, that is a middle region of the cortex. Okay, so that's a blue green algae, that is the presence in a, inside of this middle region of the cortex. Understood ba? Say yes or no? Yes. So what is the major duty for this blue green algae? Very good, to fixing of this nitrogen in the particular plant. Understood? Anyway, so here what is the type of this xylem bundle is present? So this is the coralloid root transverse section. How many xylem bundles are they present inside the vascular region or vascular bundle means? So they present in a triarch condition. Triarch means how many? Tri means three. Clear? So there's a three bundles of xylem bundle is present inside. So that is the exarch condition. What does mean by exarch, children? What does mean by exarch? What does mean by endarch and exarch, children? How will you find out that's a endarch and exarch? Exarch means the protoxylem towards the periphery and metaxylem towards the center. Very good. So here, this is the metaxylem. Metaxylem elements are towards the center and the protoxylem towards the periphery means, so that is we are called exarch. So opposite to tell that's endarch condition. How will you tell that's endarch condition? Very good. The protoxylem towards the center and metaxylem towards the periphery. Okay, xylem, there is comes under in a two types. One is protoxylem and another one is metaxylem. First formed element is we are called the protoxylem. Then here later formed this element is we are called the metaxylem elements. Understood from? Say yes or no? Yes, very good. So This is the one of this internal structure of this TS of transit section of the coralloid rod, or that's a normal rod. Clear? What are the regions to show this TS of rod, children? Epiblemma, very good. Cortex and vascular regions. Clear? Very, very important one of the 5-mark questions. These 4 questions are very, very important, children, along with the diagrams. All should make it thorough, these 4 questions. Okay. Yes. Second one is, we are going to learn about this transverse section of stem. Okay. So, how to, what are the layers to representing in the stem regions? So, this is the representing diagram, the transverse section of the stem diagram. Clear? So, this also, that's a young stem is very irregular in type of this one, children. So, there is the presence in a persistent type of the leaf base is present. So, this is the armor of this leaf base. That is the persistent type of the leaf base is the presence in that is outermost layer. So, this also they can be differentiated into what are the regions, means epidermis, cortex and vascular bundles. Once again, all of you try, children, what are the regions to show that is a transverse section of stem? Epidermis, cortex and vascular bundles. Understood? Yes. But first of all, that's the epidermis is the outermost layer. Okay. Already I told you stem and that's a leaf region. Outermost layer is your call. That's the name is known as epidermis. Okay. So that's the epidermis. That is covered by a very thick cuticle also present, children. So here, due to presence of this, that's a discontinuous layer. Okay, this is the epidermis layer is just discontinuous. So, this discontinuous layers, what is the reason means? So, due to presence of this leaf bases or presence, okay, the rough type of the leaf bases is presence in that is the layer. So, that way, that's outermost layer of the epidermis is discontinuous. Okay, the next one, inside that is the cortex region. Inside that is the cortex region. Okay, the second layer is they shows that's a cortex region. So this cortex region, so there is they made up of thin walled parenchyma cells or present, right? So there is they filling in that is the starch grains. So these are the items are present, and also there is they presence in a mucilaginous ducts. So this is the mucilaginous ducts and tannin. So these are the substance also they presence inside the cortex region, and also the cortical cells. So there they presence in a number of leaf traces in this cortex region. So the presence in that is that many leaf traces are present, children. So these leaf traces are just their presence in a two type of leaf traces, children. One is direct leaf traces and another one is building leaf traces. Okay, so these are the two leaf traces present. That is one of the very, very unique character of this cycas stem. Clear? The cycas system, so they presence in a, that's a cortex region, they presence in a two type of the leaf traces, children, or leaf gap. Okay, so these leaf traces, so there is that one is direct leaf trace and another one is the gridding leaf trace. So these are the two characters, that's one of the peculiar character, that's one of the unique character of this cycas species. Understood, pa? Yes. The next one, that's a secondary group. So they presence in a polycyline condition, and also so that's the epidermis region. So they presence in a phellum, and also there is a cork. So these are the things are just they formed with the replacing of this epidermis. Okay, so that's just they replacing for this epidermis. Then wood is their presence in a manocyclic type of the wood. Already we learned there is a general characteristic features, children. So all of you just remember and tell me, children, what is mean by manocyclic? So already we learned there is a two type of the wood in gymnosperm. One is manocyclic and another one is the pycnocyclic. Can you able to say that's a manocyclic? What is the nature of this manocyclic, children? Very good. So that is the porous wood. So there is very, very soft in nature. Their presence in a more parenchymatous tissues, and also their presence in a wide medullary ring. Okay, so there is their presence in a wide medullary ring. That is their condition. Very good. One of the examples is the cycas species. Okay. Once again, all of you repeated, what is the characteristic features of manna cell? Good. There's a porous. Very good. It's a very soft in nature. The more parenchymata cells, so they present in a wide medullary rings are present. So that is the characteristic features of manocyclic type of food. Okay. So that's the second region is over. The cortex region is over. Then third one is, so they present in a vascular bundles. Okay. Vascular bundle means what are the things are there, children? Very good. So they present in a xylem and phloem elements. Am I correct? So here, that's a young stem means the vascular bundles are they arranging in them, arranged in that is a ring-like structures. Okay, so that's a young stem means so there is a vascular bundles are they arranged in that within a ring-like structures, children. So there they presence in a broad medullary rings also presence. The next one, what is the nature of this vascular bundle? Okay, what is the nature of this vascular bundle means? So there is the presence in a conjoined and collateral endarch and open type of the vascular bundle is they mentioning it, that is the transsection of the stem. What is the meaning of collateral, children? Very good. Xylem and phloem, the vascular bundles are they present in the same radius, but phloem is always towards outside direction. Okay, the phloem is always the presence towards the outside direction. That is, we are called that's a collateral vascular bundle. Clear? Endarch condition. What's mean by say endarch condition? Already I told you that's the exarch condition here. That's a TS of root is here. Learned that is the xylem is very good. Triarch and exarch. What is mean by exarch? So that's the things here. The concept is clear in that say exarch condition of the xylem. You can answer this endarch condition. Can you able to say, children? Try it, ma. So what is that endarch condition? Very good. The protoxylem is towards the center and metacellum towards the periphery regions. Clear? So that is the type as we are called, that's an endarch condition. What's mean the open type of vascular bundle, children? Do you remember that? What is mean the open type of vascular bundle? Very good. Xylem and phloem, that is presence in between their presence in the cambium elements means, so that is the type as we are called, that's an open type of vascular bundle. Clear? Then xylem is also their presence in the only tracheid elements. The xylem, that is, they comes under the four type of the elements, children. Xylem tracheid, xylem vessels. So these are the some type of this xylem elements. That's the among that's the type of the xylem elements. So there they presence in the which type of the xylem tissues are present? Mean tracheid elements are present. Okay, the gymnosperm. So they presence in a tracheid elements. Then phloem. Phloem also they consisting of this. So the four type of the sub elements. That is, they presence in a sieve tube elements. Phloem parenchyma and phloem fiber and companion cell. These are the sub types of the phloem elements. Okay. But what are the phloem elements are they present in a, this transverse section of the stem means? So they present in a, what is the type of the elements are present in seed tube and that is the phloem parenchyma cells are present, companion cells are totally absent. Angiosperm plants only the companion cells are present. Okay, this is the gymnosperm plants, no? So that's the companion cells are totally absent. Understood, ma? Say sir, ma? So these are the things only they are they want to learn, that's a vascular bundles. Understood, ma? Say sir, ma? Yes. The next one is we are going to learn about, that's a TS of Arrakis. Okay, so this one is the structure of TS of Arrakis. Clear? So this one also, that one is, they shows that's a four region, children: epidermis, hypodermis, ground tissues and vascular bundle. What are the four regions to show that's a transsection of Arrakis? Very good. Epidermis, hypodermis, ground tissues and vascular bundles. Let us learn that's one by one, children. Epidermis. Epidermis means where is the region is present, ma? Very good. Outermost region. That is their presence in the epidermis. That is, they covered by a very thick cuticle as they presence. The next layer is the hypodermis. So this is the outermost layer, children, epidermis. Then the greenish color is given. That is the very, very thick cuticle is present. Then inside there is the presence. That's brown color. No? That is, we are called hypodermis. Okay. Hypodermis. So there they presence in a which type of the elements, which type of the tissues means so they presence in a sclerin gigantous tissues. Okay, so parenchyma, scleroderma, parenchyma, so these are the some tissues types. Okay, so they presence in a sclerenchyma. How many rows they presence in, that is a sclerenchyma means adaxial side. Adaxial means that's the upper side. Okay, adaxial side, abaxial side. Abaxial side means lower side, adaxial side means upper side. So here the upper side they presence in a two rows of sclerenchyma tissues, and then the abaxial side, that's mean by lower side, so they presence in a many layer of this sclerenchyma cells. Okay, the next one is we are going to learn about, that's a ground tissues. This region is we are called a ground tissues. So this omega shape of this, that is the vascular bundle, except that one region. So okay, the except that's a blue color region, that is we are called the ground tissues. Okay, the ground tissues, which type of the cells are they found, means that's the parenchyma cells are present. So here that's a special features of this arrangement is that's a vascular bundle inside the ground tissues. One of the special unique character of this, that's a rachis. So here they presents in a omega shape of this. This is a shape, omega shape of this. Very good. Vascular bundles are arranged inside, that is the ground tissues, children. So that is one of the very very peculiar characteristic features of this rachis. Okay, then so that's a, if we are taking in, this is the one of the single vascular bundles, means what are the things are there, already you know that one. Okay, so here that's a each vascular bundles, so that one is they covered by a, that's a single layer of the sclerenchyma cells, children. So if we are taking in, this is the one of this vascular bundle, means this vascular bundle that is surrounded by a one of the sclerenchyma tissues, that sclerenchyma tissues only they make it in, that is the vascular bundles. Okay children, so here this sclerenchyma layer, that's a sclerenchyma layer, as we are calling, that's a name is known as bundle shaped cells. Okay, suppose if we are taking this one vascular bundle, that's a sclerenchyma cells that is covered by, that is one of the surrounding of this vascular tissues things, that's we are called, that's the sheath name is bundle shaped cells. Clear? What does mean by bundle shaped cells? So that's very very important one. Then what is that other characteristic features of this vascular bundles means? So this is the collateral and endarch and open. Already I taught that one. So what does mean by collateral type? What does mean by endarch type? And what does mean by open type? So here that's the coralloid. Sorry, this is the rachis. The rachis region also, which is the type of the vascular bundles are present. The next one. So this is the diplocyclic condition of this vascular bundles presence, right? Diplocyclic vascular bundles means, so here they presence in a centripetal and centrifugal manner of the cylinder. Okay, centripetal from base to apex, or sometimes apex to base. Clear? So that is a, that's a two type of those, that's a centripetal and a centrifugal, from center to periphery, or sometimes periphery to center. So this is the type of the two type of this xylem is present. So that's why, so this is they called as a diplocyclic condition of the vascular bundle. So here they presence in a diplocyclic, so the conditions of the vascular bundles. Okay, so today's class I taught this three transoception of this internal structure of this cycas plant, children. So all of you listen, ma. I am going to give one work, children. So already kept one class of note, no? So that note, so you should draw these three diagrams and labeling the parts. Okay, before that's the entering of this next class, so all should please try to draw this three diagram and labeling of this parts, children. This is very very important. The four transverse sections are very very important. Sometimes they will ask that's a only diagram part. In sometimes they will ask that's a essay type of the questions, diagram plus explanations parts. Okay children, so that's why, so all of you make it clearly, thoroughly learn this 3-5 mark question. So and also you have to be draw that a diagram in your class or not. Understood, ma? Thank you very much, students. Thank you, thank you, students.